Jack Wilder. Arthur Tressler and the MGM Grand proudly present The Four Horsemen.
Thank you. Tonight we would like to try something that will, well, set us a bit apart.
For our final trick, we're going to do something never before seen on a Las Vegas stage.
Or any stage, for that matter.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, we are going to rob a bank. That's a lot of excitement for a crime.
I'm getting excited. What about you, people?
Sorry, sir. There's absolutely no recording allowed during the performance.
Oh, yeah, sure, of course. Let me just put this away.
Actually, I need to take that. After the show, I can come and give it back to you.
Okay.
Okay. Now, please settle down. Now, who here has a bank they would like us to rob? That's a lot of people with the vendetta. So we'll choose one at random, then. My associates will make sure it's random, right?
Elvis, help me out, bud.
Thank you, bro.
In Jack's bowl are ping pong balls with section numbers. Jack, can you hand me a section number? Thank you. We are looking at section B. Where is section B? Okay, there. It's going to be one of you guys. Get ready. All right, I don't know why everybody's happy. It's only them. Merritt, can I get a row, please? Thank you, Merritt. We are looking at row number 5. Where is that? And Henley, can I please have a random seat number? Ah, lucky number 13, B513, where are you? Sir, please stand up. Ah, there you are, hi. Great, and could you just confirm for me that this is in fact your seat, B513?
Yes.
Okay, wonderful. Now, could you please tell us your name and the name of your bank?
Well, my name is Etienne Forcier, and my bank, it's Crédit Républicain de Paris.
French, okay. We were hoping for something a little more local, a kind of mom-and-pop credit union with no security, but that's fine. Promise is a promise. Could you please come up to the stage? We'll rob your bank. And while he does that, there is someone here tonight without whom we would just be four magicians working the circuit, trying to get here. You probably know this man, if not from one of the many, many companies he puts his name on. He is our friend, he is our benefactor, Mr. Arthur Tressler. Please stand up, Art. Please stand up.
The only man here with the Queen's cell phone number.
Actually, please stay standing, Art. I want to say that when we came to Mr. Tressler, we promised that as a unit, we could become the biggest name in magic.
So we wanted to say thank you. And by the way, Art, you notice on the sign out front, we made sure we put your name on top.
If you turn out to be as good as you think you are, dear girl, that won't be necessary much longer.
We haven't done our closer yet. Why don't you watch it, and then you can decide for yourself. Ladies and gentlemen, Arthur Tressler.
Thank you. And of course, once again, the Cardinal of Clairvoyance, Merritt McKinney.
Etienne, what Jack is bringing to the stage now is what we in the magic world call a teleportation helmet. You will need to wear this, as it will allow you to literally fold through space and time to your bank
in the 8th? 9th?
Yeah.
Arrondissement.
Now, once you are there, we will be able to speak with you through this helmet. Now, oh my God, that's beautiful. It has the added attraction of being very stylish. It's about time the French learned from America on that subject. Is that a beautiful piece of headgear?
Thank you, Rick.
It is.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
May we.
But before you go anywhere, could you please pick a card, any card? Not that card.
Ooh. No, that's okay. It's an old American joke. You can take that one.
Okay.
There you go. Now, show it to your friends in section B there, but not to us. Okay, great. Now, if you could just sign your name there. In English, if possible.
Yeah, that's good.
Thanks. Put it in your pocket.
And now for one tiny detail.
Thank you.
Etienne, let's step into this cockamamie contraption. And I'll step off of it. Bonne chance.
It's 11:50 p.m. here in Vegas. That's 8:50 a.m. in Paris. Your bank opens in less than 10 minutes.
One, two,
three.
What the fuck? Whoa. Wow.
Etienne.
It wasn't supposed to happen like that, was it?
Etienne.
I like that little French guy.
Where'd he go?
Wait, there he is.
No, please. This is Daniel Atlas, can you hear me? Etienne, are you okay?
Yes.
Perfect. What do you see in there?
Money. Is this real?
Yes, looks like 3 million or so euros worth.
What a fashion.
Okay, now here's what we're gonna need you to do. I want you to take the card that you signed out of your pocket, and I want you to take the ticket stub from tonight's show, and I want you to put it right there in the middle of the money. Now, drop it. On the side of your helmet, you should feel a button. Now, don't press it just yet. Now, that button activates an air duct that connects Paris to Las Vegas. Okay, good. Now you can press it.
All right, now, Etienne, hold on tight. You might feel a bit of a vacuum.
Wait a second.
Oh, my God.
Thank you.